here to celebrate one of the greatest Nigerian lawyers that ever lived.
On that note, I would like to invite my ladyship, Justice Bimbo, I can see God in there. Just to go back, her sisters, again, I worked in Icon, and we used to visit them in their house in Cameroon in the 1980s. So I'm happy to see her here and sit beside her. So, Justice Bimbo, 10 minutes. Thank you.
I have to say, after Mr. Femifala has spoken, I don't know what to say. After the professor has spoken, neither do I know what to say. After Dr. Naidu Mohammed has spoken, maybe I will say for the last give the ruling. Or maybe the judgment. But then I tell God that I looked at the pamphlet and find that he says comments. So I'm only here to comment. I will not go to the left, neither would I go to the right. And I don't know whether I should doff my hat, that is, take it down as a judge, or I should stand alone as a people. I really don't know what to do, but I hope God will help me. Well, Chief used to say that hard work does not kill. It is laziness that kills. I have come to agree with him. Again, he used to say, and I think it's a common saying, that you can never know more than the elders. You can have as many new clothes as possible, but you can never have as much rags as an elder. You can't. The king, they used to beat his senior wife. Yale. Where did they put it? Who is he waiting for? Exactly. And that is what the judges and the lawyers are today. They used the king to beat the judges. The lawyers were happy. They joined in the fight. And then they remembered again. Where is that king? And who is the king going to? That is what is happening now. That is what is happening now. You see, Kehinde Sofola, S.A.M., Chief Kehinde Sofola, Father Sofola, Brother Sofola, Friend Sofola, Doctor Sofola, Advisor Sofola, Counselor Sofola. He was there to all of us. In a situation like this, I remember, he would quickly call his colleagues. FRA, Showbiz, Joe and Jay, they would quickly have an emergency meeting and they would meet and decide the way forward. What is happening? What am I hearing? What are they saying? And you act accordingly. Before morning, you see things will begin to change. They will begin to pay visits to the Chief Judge, the Chief Justice, the organizations, the bar, and you begin to move things. And by morning, you find another story. But today, every man to his own, God for us. The elders have abandoned the sheep. The younger ones are looking for their fathers. Some are looking for their mothers. But there's no hope. Yes. The judiciary is the last hope of the common man. Who makes up the judiciary? Is it not the lawyers? Who makes up the judiciary of tomorrow? Is it not the law school student? Is it not the university student in the law faculty? Our topic is the role of the legal profession in nation building. It involves the lawyers, the law students, the law professors, the judges. That's what makes up the legal profession. A few moments ago, I was talking to my friend, SAM, and we're talking about, oh, before those days, we used to have a panel of people come together and analyze judgment and bring out the salient points and look at the impact on the society, rightly or wrongly. But today, what has happened? Everybody has gone to become an SA, a PA, to politicians, leaving the law profession abandoned. To whom? To students who have not yet found their feet, to people who have abandoned the law profession, and all of a sudden they have become top professionals, professionals as politicians. What do you do when you find your television on? You walk into the system, you begin to hear commentaries. From whom? And then you ask, is that man a lawyer? Are you sure he's a lawyer? And then phone calls, did he meet you in the law school or you met him? No, he didn't finish. Did he finish? No, he went to do something else. That is what we find today. The comments we hear, they are unreliable. They are not coming from people who are well trained. What is happening? Chikene Sofola would have been aghast. Would have taken a walk to the law school to see what is going on here. What am I hearing? The other day, a cousin of mine was attending the tutorial in Lagos. And what did she have to say when she came back? Auntie, when I was in another campus, they didn't teach me like this, so they teach better in Lagos. And I was wondering, do you have different standards in the campuses? So who's turning out? Does it depend on where you were trained? What about the lawyers? Does it depend on who trains you? Do they train these days? In Kehinde Sofola, you are well trained. From the day you attend that office, you hit the ground running. The next day, fire is thrown at you. You are going to court for, you will move in motion, you open your mouth, you talk. Stand your ground. Do you hear me? I don't feel good. But today, my principal is unavoidably absent. He has asked me to take an adjournment. On the day of the hearing, on the day of the hearing, and this case is like 12 years old, and the appeal court, 12 years old. And you look at the clients behind you, and you wonder, do you care about this client's winning? Do you care about the case? Or is it just another golden hen? When are we going to kill this hen? Or is it the egg we have to remove? We all have to come together. Be you a lawyer, a lecturer, a judge. We just have to move this profession forward. We have a great role to play. In every area in Nigeria, you find a lawyer. You may not practice, but once you're a lawyer in your own household, any question that has the mark of any legality, they come and meet you. Body, what are you saying about this man? And you don't know anything. You're the first lawyer. What advice are you giving? To even your clients. That is what we find today. Some cases ought not to be in court. And you find two similar lawyers fighting over the case. And you wonder, is it the hen or the egg? What are they fighting about? This is something you conveniently have settled in your office. And then, the prof talks about timidity. Timidity, where is my protection? Where is my protection? What do you want me to do? How do you follow the law? I cannot expand it. If I try it, I'll be accused of judicial rascality. Judicial activism, that is all manner of what you call. And so we stick to our mandate. Interpret the law as it is. They didn't send you on an errand. Yes. You go beyond your brief. You are told you are entering into the arena. You are told you are biased. The petition flies. The precious time you use to write another judgment or a ruling, you use it to be answering petition and be making copies of the file to attach and send. Why would timidity not rain? It would rain. It would rain. The You give your judgment, the next day they look you in the eye and say, I have no intention of even honoring that judgment. And what do? The client, the lawyer comes and says, my lord, we won on the high court. The judge said, the ruling said, they said section, my lord, they must pay. What do you do? Can you enforce it? No, the judiciary is slowly becoming a toothless bulldog. You can only talk, you can't enforce. But in paper, you are supposed to enforce. How do you do that? You send a child to go and fetch water from the river. You take his calabash. How is he supposed to fetch the water? And you accuse him of laziness. How? Let's look inwards. Let's look inwards. My people say, Ibi Okane, Ego Noko Ike. The chief cannot be so angry as to break the royal beads on his neck. That is what is happening. You are so angry at the judiciary. You are so angry at the lawyers. So, you want to desecrate the institution. And what happens? What happens? When the peace goes, what do you have? The executive, the legislature, and the judiciary. Now, when the judiciary is, I hope you replace the judiciary. That's the meaning. You talk about civility. Yes! What do you want us to do? You don't protect us. Do you protect us? It's only a salary that is guaranteed. My uncle retires from the Supreme Court bench. He has to lose his back. Nobody cares. Nobody cares. He has to lose his back because he has been sitting all the way. They say they pay you big salary. Fine, how do you spend it? You only spend it by writing checks from your table every day. You can't go anywhere. You can't. There's no time. And then you are asked, why is it that your driver is the one cashing the check every time? Why won't your driver cash the check? Can you go to the bank? When you manage to go to the bank, you are queried, are you sure you are just so? Because nobody sees you, yet you are being accused. We have a life to live, you know. We are only human. We have children. We pay school fees. We do everything you do as well. The body is onerous, therefore, we demand protection. You spend the whole day writing. You get back, your fingers are numb. They are numb, you can't write anymore. This judge is lazy. You can't write anymore. You do it for 5 years, and all this tells you you have to operate. This finger goes straight to your heart, your neck is shaking. What happens? Where is security? Well, because of a few eggs threw away the judiciary. It's only fair. If you look inwards, your brother may be a judge, your sister may be a judge, your father may have been a judge. But remember, he has a life to live. After he leaves the judiciary, what next? Where does it go to? After you leave the judiciary, you are put up there, and then you retire, go to a jungle to find a place. You are put up there, you are standing at the airport, you are trying to catch the plane. Hurry, hurry, the flight is leaving. Can't you see I'm in a hurry and you're taking baby steps? That's what's happened to us. Yeah, you go, the more difficult it is. It will interest you to know that we have 1,200 judges all over, from Supreme Court to Customary Court of Appeal. Only for Nigeria, 1,200. Look at the ratio. Look at the ratio. Compare it. Somebody has a docket in Lagos of about 400 cases. You have 1,000. The next person has about 200. The next one has 300 in Mori. If you're in Port Harcourt, God help you. You have a lot for your docket. And you are the only one. And you are slow. Talking about adjournment. Yes. I was accused of being 2 weeks judgment because I gave 2 weeks when I was sitting in Abuja. 2 weeks I judgment. But I paid the price. I paid the price. Every 2 weeks you are done and then you are watching your docket. You are watching the cases go by. Realize that we have too many. We can't have it 2 weeks. I moved it to 1 month. Because you are, there is no duplicate. How? One judge has 500. Can he hear every, just a case, every day? You said I should give 3 weeks. For 4 days, we finish the case. Can we finish it in 4 days? On the first day, we have gone far. The lawyer gets up. My lord, I think I can't make it. We have to cancel those days. I have a very important meeting in Abuja. There goes your case. Your fixture is gone. And you have to retire your returns in 3 months. You find the judges fighting with the lawyers in court. You must go on. You must go on. Why? She needs your return. She needs to make the return. There's a minimum every month, every quarter. You know you must finish the case. There's no adjustment. Why? Because she has to make the return. And then you're accused. Why are you so interested in the case? Why must you be so fast about the case? The same people who accuse you of laziness are the same people who accuse you of unusual speed at the altar of sacrifice. What do you do? You cannot lift the cup up, you cannot put it down. It's like the man who has the horse. He puts his child, you accuse him. He stays on the horse, you accuse him. Nobody stays on the horse, you accuse him. So what do you want him to do? What is the way forward? What is really the way forward? We talk about the Federal High Court and the High Court dichotomy. Yes, it's both over and over and over again. Why don't you look at the law? Isn't there a way we can say, okay, two of the beliefs relate to me. I will hear these two and refer you to the other court. Because really, you see a litigant. The lawyer that are opposed at the High Court, it is a Federal High Court matter. It is a lawyer that goes to the Federal High Court when you now file and says, no, it's a High Court matter. Which other court do you go to? What about the owner of the case? Who is there? 10 years, or the case in the Court of Appeal. 13 years, they are fighting over to me. What do you want the judge to do? A matter in which the judge says, this case is 25 years old. You are fighting over the Volkswagen that was seized. Volkswagen is no longer manufactured. You make an order that Volkswagen be released to you. Is it fair? And the man is a common driver. Okay. What is the price? Let's quantify it. And you say, let's move on. Quantify it. Now this is the amount. Instead, Volkswagen is not in use. You can't find the part anymore, therefore, pay him XY. The lawyer goes, why? Your brief was only to Volkswagen. Why would you? Talking about judicial stability. How else do you want them to do? It is the same lawyer, the same lawyer. Maybe lawyers should check it. It's not about going on and on just to please your client. It's about moving the judicial, moving the profession forward. Moving the profession forward is key. Talking about training, I think judges should be trained. Judges should be trained. It is very important. I remember I was appointed in 2004, just 2 weeks after. That was the only, what was it? When some of you were with me. That was the only training we had till today. So, you learn every day. How? From your training, from inception. I remember I came to Jokola and Co. Chief will never allow you to stay with another person, another lawyer over a case. He would never. If he catches you, you are in trouble. If he gives you a file, you would look at that file, you would do the research, and you would write whatever it is you want to write for him alone. He would correct it to the red Bible and send it back to you. If he catches you talking to Ronke, why are you using Ronke's head? It was your head I employed, not Ronke's head. Do you understand? That teaches you research. It teaches you how to actually go around. Now he taught us another thing. Time. You must stay in the office. All of us were in the office between 7 and 8, no matter where you live. And you cannot use the lift. You must do what? Climb up. And we thought it was punishing us. But today with NEPA, we can climb very well. You understand? So what I'm saying is that you pick up lessons as you go on. You must be mindful of our youngsters coming up. Now they see you. Mommy, is this what you do? You're always doing homework. Mommy, who is your teacher? Mommy, I don't think I want to be a doctor. You're always writing, always writing, always writing. I think I want to be a doctor. We're scaring away the junior ones. Mommy, they're not impressed. They are not impressed. Really, we should look inward. What again? We should build more courts. We have 1,200 and you are complaining. The adjournment is long. It's no long. You cannot give that judge. The judge will tell you, if I drop dead today, the work will continue. Like I tell lawyers, if the client, if the lawyer drop dead, the client will go there, you know, sorry, oh, please, this is my file I came to collect. He's going to the next court. Chief used to say, he has never seen a file follow a lawyer to the grave. That file goes on. What is it telling you? Yourself first, protect yourself. Health-wise, protect yourself. Job-wise, protect yourself. And that is why lawyers are looking. They're protecting their jobs. You can't, because of a few eggs, throw the water away. Now, you can't even go out. At the airport, they say, my lord, you won't even answer. Because, your lord, I'm a thief, please. That is the meaning. You can't even go out with your official. In fact, when it happened, everybody changed. No official label. You change it and use the normal. We're all floor members, don't worry. I'm not hired, it's just that I'm a judge, but we're okay. That is what it has come to now. There's fear everywhere. You grew up with a lawyer. You went to school with a lawyer. You shared table with a lawyer. You did dinners with a lawyer. And then you were a lawyer. And then you were elevated. They say, don't talk to the lawyer. Why don't you talk to the lawyer? We have to be careful. We have to be careful. As it is, from December, lawyers stop talking to judges. Am I lying?
No.
Lawyers stop talking to judges. Judges also respected themselves. But last week, see what happened. I want to see the late wife. There's this new rule that if you want to be, let's say, we have to get your email. We need your reference. How do I give you my email? Please, oh. There's CFCC. What do you want my email? They say they want my email, your email, because they want to send you a letter so you can do the reference for them. How do I do a reference for you? The fear of PFC is the beginning of wisdom. How? Would I not be accused? Would I not be asked to bring a list of my cases to show whether you have appeared before me and my account? Is that not what is going on? This is the fear. And I think I speak for my colleagues. This is the fear. Why name that rule when you know that you will accuse us? Why? You have not been talking to us. We have decided we are no longer lawyers. Oh yeah, we are just stand on our side of the room. But how does that work? This is the fear. I have a lot of people who were supposed to come to me. They are saying, no, don't want to again. I think I better continue. Because they are scared. I'm talking about, if all of us decide to abuse the judiciary, everybody decides to desecrate the judiciary, where do you go? I think we should help one another. We should assist one another. I think we should put heads together to see what's the problem. And you see, the funny thing is that it's not as if they don't know the bad ones. They know the bad ones. Let's not deceive ourselves. They know the bad ones. But they just want to snare everybody. Spoil the institution. And what happens? You'll be affected. The next generator will be affected. And who will be doing the ideals of chief of service? Who would not? Who would have been accused of abandoning ship? What else do I want to talk about? I want to talk